My name is Samson Stella, and I'm a researcher at the Laboratory of Tissue Engineering and Cell Culture, Nicolae Testimițianu, Republic of Moldova. I will present the next topic, techniques of dental pulp decellularization. So, regeneration of endodontic tissue shows promise in treating dental pulp diseases. However, no suitable scaffolds exist for pulp regeneration. Different natural, biological, extracellular matrix could be used as scaffolds for tissue regeneration. This study is dedicated for investigation of characteristic of decellularized dental pulp from extracted wisdom teeth and evaluated why it could mediate pulp regeneration. Decellularized dental pulp represents a suitable scaffold for improving clinical outcomes and function of teeth with dental pulp disease. So the dental pulp is a soft vascularized tissue located in the pulp cavity. It consists of endothelial cells, fibroblasts, lymphocytes, and odontoblasts. The sensorial protective function of a healthy pulp dentin complex is very important for the teeth activity during the whole life. The pulp provides nutrient supply to the teeth, dentin formation, sensing, and defense. Pulpitis or pulp necrosis is a common disease caused by trauma and dental caries because of a small root canal volume and narrow apical foramen. In case of a dental pulp inflammation, blood supply to the pulp becomes insufficient and often causes unrecoverable pulp necrosis. In nowadays, development of regenerative medicine provides new ideas to regenerate dental pulp, recovering its biological function for maintaining dental normal activity. By transplanting stem cells, growth factors, or biological scaffold into the dental cavity, it should be achieved functional pulp regeneration. Biological extracellular matrix scaffolds play an important role in teeth tissue engineering by providing a temporary three-dimensional special structure and extracellular matrix complex to maintain the regenerative environment and stem cell function. The extracellular matrix is essential for cell differentiation, proliferation, survival, migration, and promote tissue and organ regeneration. Various scaffolds have been used in a dental pulp regeneration, including acrylic acid and collagen, but the major problem is lack of dental pulp extracellular matrix, thus limiting the ability to form dentin. Therefore, it is essential to construct a dental pulp regeneration scaffold containing dental pulp extracellular matrix to promote odontoblast differentiation and dentin formation. A cellular natural extracellular matrix to promote odontoblast differentiation and dentin formation is used as a biological scaffold for presenting the anatomical structure of a natural organ and extracellular matrix. A cellular natural extracellular matrix has been used for skin, diaphragm, blood vessel, liver regeneration. Extracellular matrix used for tissue regeneration is basically derived from biological tissue. Therefore, the present study investigates the structure and composition of decellularized dental pulp. Material and methods, what we used in this study. This study was conducted in accordance with the requirements of ethic commitment and an informative agreement or an informative agreement close to every patient. In order to achieve the objectives outlined in this study, research was performed according to the clinical investigation protocol, which includes the collection and interpretation of data, anamnestic, objective clinical examination, paraclinical examination result. The teeth were extracted for orthodontic and prophylactic reasons. After processing the oral cavity with betadine solution, local anesthesia is performed with septanest solution 4%. After performing the syndesmotomy, the actual extraction of the tooth takes place when the suture is applied. The extracted teeth are pressed with 7% of ethanol solution and then placed in sterile test tubes containing DMEM. Nutrient medium, antifungals, antibiotics to be transported to the laboratory for decellularization procedures. The excised dental pulp was mounted to the perfusion system and washed with 0.1-0.3 liter of distilled water. And after the decellularization, we used two protocols. First protocol is with 1.25% sodium dodecyl sulfate, and the second, after washing, of a dental pulp with citrate phosphate dextrose, the chelation was done with 0.25% SDA solution. Subsequently, the dental pulp was washed 3 times with 1% of buffered saline solution. After the segments of native and decellularized dental pulp were fixed in 10% formalin, late was performed morphological investigation and hematoiosin staining. Nucleic acid counting was performed according to the QIAM blood mini kit extraction protocol. Each sample was quantified in the nanodrop thermoscientific spectrometer. The hydroxyproline content was determined on spectrophomer based on the oxidation of hydroxyproline in pyrrole under the action of chloramine B. The results, the macroscopic evaluation of a dental pulp at the experiment beginning show that after its washing with distilled water, first method, and with distilled water and citrate dextrose phosphate, second method, in the second method, the dental pulp became pale in comparison to the first one. We can see it in the first picture. And however, this visual difference in perfusion liquid quality observed, the perfusion liquid obtained after washing using the distilled and anticoagulant mixture has more intense brown color, which it explains it more efficient removal of blood cover clothes. We can see here in the first picture with distilled water and here with the distilled water and citrate dextrose phosphate. The macroscopic result after decellularization showed uniform dental pulp decellularization and a whitish color in the second experimental lot compared to the first lot, where dental pulp was washed without anticoagulant solution. The yellow color indicates the presence of a cellular residue. In the case of decellularization dental pulp scaffolds without using the anticoagulant solution, we have observed that there are cellular conglomerates, necrotic detritus, and autolysed cell conjunctival dental pulp architecture is disorganized. The vascular wall is in some portion with a contracted contour and perivascular autolysed cellular elements. We can see here the decellularized dental pulp with colorating with hematoxin eosin. The decellularization dental pulp scaffolds with SDS and initially washed with anticoagulant showed histological depiction of contour of a central vascular wall, very thin conjunctival architecture. The thickened contour of a vascular wall is clarified by the presence of collagen fibers, which is a favorable condition for the matrices using the recellularization. Here we can see that the decellularization dental pulp hematoxin eosin with anticoagulant. The discussion. A correct selected method of decellularization allowed to preserve a normal structure of extracellular scaffold. This is, will have an influence on cell differentiation proliferation after scaffold repopulation. The received three-dimensional matrices contain small amount of residual cellular material, so the matrices are less immunogenic, which would not lead to immunological post-transplantation resection. Some efforts show that extracellular matrix preserve a structural component such as collagen and laminin. And in our research, with hydroxyproline content revealed the preservation of architecture of the obtained matrix. It is very important the evaluation of a detergent influence on the extracellular matrix structure. We have used the sodium dodecyl sulfate ionic detergent that complete cell removal, but also it may help to obtain a matrix with improved chemical, physical, biological properties. In conclusion, I wanted to add that the DNA content after dental pulp decellularization show that decellularization of sodium dodecyl sulfate has better result. The used decellularization method maintains the connective architecture and form of a dental pulp. Obtained extracellular matrix probably could be used for the tissue bioengineering in dental pulp reconstruction. Thank you for your attention.
Thank you very much for your very interesting presentation. If are any questions? Only a small question. Do you intend to continue your study and to populate again this scaffold with the cells?
For sure. This is my thesis topic, so we'll absolutely continue to repopulate the cell in the future for sure in our laboratory with our professor, Dr. Nako, for sure.
Thank you.